The Titanic, that infamous unsinkable passenger liner that sank to the bottom of the Atlantic Ocean in the early 1900s, was of astronomic proportions. It weighed in at over 46,000 tons. That's over three times the weight of the Brooklyn Bridge. But its rudder was minuscule by comparison, only 100 tons, or less than 1% of the ship's total weight. What's that have to do with today's devotion? Well, I'm glad you asked. In James chapter 3, the topic is the great power of the human tongue, even though it's only a small part of our body. In comparing the power of the tongue, in verse 3, James says that we can make a large horse go wherever we want with a small bit in its mouth. A tiny spark can set a great forest on fire, and a small rudder makes a huge ship turn wherever the pilot chooses. James goes on to say in verse 7, people can tame all kinds of animals, birds, reptiles, and fish, but no one can tame the tongue. It is restless and evil, full of deadly poison. Sometimes it praises our Lord and Father, and sometimes it curses those who have been made in the image of God. And so blessing and cursing come pouring out of the same mouth. Surely, my brothers and sisters, this is not right, James concludes. So what hope do we have against the tongue? How do we tame this most powerful part of our bodies? James says, only with understanding that comes through the wisdom of God. And here's what that wisdom looks like, beginning in verse 17. The wisdom from above is first of all pure. It is also peace-loving, gentle at all times, and willing to yield to others. It is full of mercy and good deeds. It shows no favoritism and is always sincere. And those who are peacemakers will plant seeds of peace and reap a harvest of righteousness. God's wisdom, it's the key to taming the tongue. So let's use it today to control the words that we say.